The next application of hyperconjugation is heat of hydrogenation. Heat of hydrogenation. In short, we'll write it as HOH. Okay. So, what is heat of hydrogenation? It is the amount of energy released when one mole of an alkene amount of energy released when 1 mole of an alkene goes under hydrogenation. Okay, why 1 mole we are using here? Because you see, heat or energy, heat of hydrogen is nothing but energy. Energy is extensive property. Okay, energy is an extensive property. So whenever we define extensive property, we have to define the amount also that we are taking. So standard amount we always take is 1 mole only. Okay, so when 1 mole of alkene will go under hydrogenation, the amount of energy released is nothing but the heat of hydrogenation. For example, you see, suppose this is the alkene we have and it is going under hydrogenation. The product we get here is C single bond C H H plus del H, right? So energy releases in this process. So this stands what? It is an exothermic process. Why it is exothermic process? Because you see, there is one pi bond here, right? The pi bond between carbon-carbon atoms, okay? And the sigma bond between hydrogen-hydrogen atom, okay? Sigma bond. So here what happens, one pi bond and one sigma bond breaks and this converts into 2 sigma bond, carbon hydrogen sigma bond, 2 sigma bond. So what happens, sigma bond is stronger than pi bond, okay? So from less strong we are going towards the more strong. So obviously here it is more stable, so energy will release. Okay, so since what happens, 1 sigma and pi bond dissociates and forms 2 sigma bond, which is a stronger bond, hence energy releases. Okay, so this is what the process we have here, heat of hydrogenation. Now you see, one example if I take here, plus H2, the product will be what here? It is butane, right? Both the product is same, butane. The energy releases here, suppose it is del HA, and here the energy releases is del HB. Why A? Because I have taken this molecule as A and this molecule as B. Okay, so energy releases with a molecule A on hydrogenation is del HA. Energy releases with molecule B on hydrogenation is del HB. If I ask you A and B, which one is more stable? Stability of A and B, if you compare, stability of B is more than to that of A. Why B is more stable? Because more alpha hydrogen. Here you see the number of alpha hydrogen is 6 and here the number of alpha hydrogen is 2. More alpha hydrogen, more will be the stability. Both reactants, different reactants gives different same product, okay, that is butane. So if I write down the energy diagram here, right, since A is less stable, so its energy is more than B, right? B is more stable, energy will be less, okay? And the product is, suppose here we have the product, exothermic reaction, so this will have the least energy among the three, right? So product is same, so the path of the reaction could be like this or it could be like this. Okay, now the enthalpy change in this reaction is what? The enthalpy change is nothing but this. This is for del HB, right? And enthalpy change for this will be, this is del HA. Okay, so from this graph what we can say that the mod of del HA is more than to the mod of del HB, and which is more stable? B is more stable. So more stable product, right, sorry, more stable reactant will give lesser value of enthalpy change. Okay, so what we can say, the stability from this data, we can say the stability is inversely proportional to the enthalpy change del H, which is nothing but the heat of hydrogenation. Okay, so more stable compound gives you less energy, less stable compound gives you more energy. How do we assign stability? By hyperconjugation, by resonance, by aromaticity, any factor we can use. But one thing is very important and definitely true here is more stable compounds when go under hydrogenation gives lesser value of enthalpy change. Okay, that is what we get from here. Okay, now on basis of this we'll see, or we'll compare some heat of hydrogenation of some compounds. Okay, remember one thing always, stability is inversely proportional to del H. Now this stability we can compare on the basis of hyperconjugation, on the basis of resonance, or any other electronic effects. Okay, if only hyperconjugation is there, then we'll compare through hyperconjugation. If hyperconjugation, resonance both are there, we'll compare through resonance. Resonance will be the dominating effect, and more stable, less will be the enthalpy change. So whatever example we have done just before in in the stability of alkene, right, the stability order, if you reverse those order, you will get the order of heat of hydrogenation. Okay, because it is inversely proportional. Okay, we'll see few examples now also, but whatever examples we have done just now in stability of alkene, those examples also you can refer for heat of hydrogenation. The only thing you have to do is what? Write down the order of heat of hydrogenation for all those examples that we have done. The reverse order of that, just opposite order of that, gives you the order of heat of hydrogenation. Okay, you look at this, we'll solve some questions onto this now. Okay, now one more thing important here, I forgot to tell you that this order we got for the molecule which has equal number of pi bonds. Okay, so this this thing we can apply when the molecule has equal number of pi bonds, then only we can take this as the reference. Okay, what happens when the pi bonds are not equal? In that case, the heat of hydrogenation is directly proportional to the number of pi bonds, because more number of pi bonds, more will be the hydrogenation takes place, more energy will release. Okay, so this is the first case when molecule has equal number of pi bonds, stability is inversely proportional to del H. Okay, when the molecule has different number of pi bonds, then the heat of hydrogenation, delta H of hydrogenation, is directly proportional to the number of pi bonds. Okay, so like this we compare. So both examples, both parts are important. We'll see a few examples onto this, then you will understand how to compare the heat of hydrogenation of given molecules. Okay. Now I'll write down few examples. Okay, then we solve this. Okay. Now these examples, you see, we have to compare HOH, heat of hydrogenation. Two molecules has different number of pi bonds, so more pi bonds, more will be the heat of hydrogenation. Okay, equal number of pi bonds, okay, then we'll see what, we'll see the more stable compound will give you least. Which one is more stable? You see, this is in conjugation, resonance possible here. Here the resonance is possible, but here the resonance is not possible. We have here hyperconjugation. Okay, resonance is, gives more stable product. Okay, so this is more stable than this, hence heat of hydrogenation of this product will be more. Okay, now here you see we have resonance possible here, and here again we have heat of, sorry, hyperconjugation. Order of heat of hydrogenation will be this. Okay, one exception we have here. If you compare these three molecules, okay, so all the three molecules has different number of pi bonds. So if you see the normal thing, heat of hydrogenation, number of pi bonds, according to this, if I write down this as A, B and C, okay, A, B and C, then the order should be what? C should have maximum, then B and then C, because it has the maximum number of pi bonds. Okay, but since this compound is aromatic and this aromaticity gives extra stability to this compound, okay, and that is why the order is not that we are assuming now. Okay, this two, if you compare, obviously greater number of pi bonds, okay, more will be the heat of hydrogenation. B should be more than A, that's a true thing. But A and C, if you compare, however it is aromatic, the order is found to be this. This is the order of HOH for this molecule. This is an exception actually. So you must remember this exception. Okay, very important. So like this, we can compare heat of hydrogenation according to the number of pi bonds present in the molecule. Equal number of pi bonds, then we'll see what, we'll check the stability. Reverse of that gives you the order of heat of hydrogenation. Okay, if the equal number of pi bonds are not there, then the heat of hydrogenation is directly proportional to the number of pi bonds. Okay, and accordingly we'll do all this example. Okay, so you can go through this, we'll see the next application. The next application we are going to see here is heat of combustion. That is HOC. So what is heat of combustion? The amount of energy released when one mole of a substance is burned into air. Okay. So here what happens, the, we can also say this is similar to heat of hydrogenation. Few, just few things you have to keep in mind. It is the amount of energy released, right? So if I write down the reaction CXHY, any hydrocarbon, plus X plus Y by 4O2 gives XCO2 plus Y H2O. Y by 2H2O. Okay, this is the balanced reaction. Okay, now this is the combustion reaction. What is combustion? It is the amount of energy released when one mole of a substance is burned into air. It is the amount of energy released when 1 mole of a substance is burned into air. Okay, exothermic process it is. Okay, now this substance can be anything, it can be alkane, alkene, anything. Okay, so the energy released here also the same thing we have. Energy released due to combustion is inversely proportional to the stability of the compound. Now if the compound is alkene, then again we'll consider all those factors to assign stability, that is hyperconjugation or resonance, anything, right? But this is true when we have, in case of equal number of carbon atoms, number of carbon atoms, if the molecule has equal number of carbon atoms, then the order will be this. Okay, what happens if the molecule has different number of carbon atoms? Carbon atoms, the delta H of combustion is directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms. Right? Now we see few examples here. Okay, so for all these molecules, we have to compare the heat of combustion. Okay, now you see this molecule, first of all we'll see what, whether the carbon atoms is equal or not. Okay, so we'll see what, 5 carbon atoms. Okay, then we'll check what, stability, equal number of carbon atoms, we'll check stability, and stability is because of hyperconjugation here, because that is only possible. Hyperconjugation, we have 9 hydrogen and here we have only 2, 3, 5 hydrogen. So stability of this is more, right? Stability of the first one is more, and hence the heat of combustion of second one is more. Okay, here you see number of alpha hydrogen, if you see here it is more, right? But here we don't compare stability because both molecule has different number of carbon atoms. Here we have 6, but here we have 8. Different number of carbon atoms, then the delta H is directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms. Order will be this. Different number of carbon atoms, delta H will be directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms. Here the number of carbon atoms are same. Then we'll check what? Stability. Okay. The stability of this will be least. Least stable. Why it is least stable? Because of maximum angle strain. Because of maximum angle strain. Okay. So because of maximum angle strain, least stable, and hence the order of heat of combustion will be this. Okay. So this is how we compare the heat of combustion of different molecule. Okay. But in this we have one more thing. So the thing you have to keep in mind is you have to count first the number of carbon atoms. If it is same, then we'll check stability. And how do we check stability? We can have the factor of hyperconjugation, resonance, anything. Okay. Reverse of that will be the order of heat of combustion. If you have different number of carbon atoms, then more carbon atoms gives you the more number, more heat of combustion. Okay. We can have one more possibility here. And that possibility is what? If the molecule contains double bond also and different number of carbon atoms. Okay. If the molecule contains double bond with different number of carbon atoms, then stability will define with the help of what? The number of carbon atoms there. Okay. So the last point here, these two cases we have discussed. So third case, if the molecule has double bond but different number of carbon atoms. So in case of double bond, we can apply those hyperconjugation and all, but that is only possible when we have equal number of carbon atoms, like you see this one. This is the fourth molecule. The molecule has double bond but different number of carbon atoms, so stability will define according to the number of carbon atoms. So that, sorry, the heat of hydrogenation, molecule double bond but different carbon atoms. So in this case, what we'll write, the delta H of combustion, not hydrogenation, delta H of combustion is directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms. Right, so this is the case we have missed. The number of carbon atom will dominate the double bond stability factor here. So the order of delta H of combustion will be this. Okay, so these are the three cases we have discussed to compare the delta H of combustion. Okay, when the molecule has equal number of carbon atoms, delta H is inversely proportional to stability. When the molecule has different number of carbon atoms, delta H is directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms. Mainly it is true in case of alkane, cycloalkane. Okay, third case is what, when the molecule contains double bond but different number of carbon atoms. So in that case, what we'll write, delta H of combustion is directly proportional to the number of carbon atoms, and the order of the molecule will be this. Okay, so this is it we have discussed so far, hyperconjugation and how hyperconjugation is applicable in case of alkene, and there are various application also we have discussed, that is delta H of combustion, stability of alkene and delta H of hydrogenation. Okay, next class we are going to discuss about the hyperconjugation in carbocation and free radical.